Hello, it's Scott Manley here with a Kerbal example of just how big distances in space are. I built this tiny little capsule. It's basically a mainsail engine. It has the smallest crew cabin on top of it. And, well, that's it. There's not any fuel in it. I'm, of course, using the infinite fuel cheat to make this thing take off at some ridiculous acceleration. And Thompney Kerman looks like he's having some problem dealing with it, I think. Regardless, look, we are heading up through the atmosphere. We're getting shock heating. We're getting aerodynamic effects. And, well, within, 30 seconds, we're already out of the atmosphere. We're already up into space under a minute, right? This is going like a bat out of hell, but the reason I'm doing this is because I want to make another discussion about traveling long distances. Now, some people have asked, will there be other solar systems in Kerbal Space Program, and will you be able to travel to them? So I just want to say, we talk about what it would take to travel to other solar systems using Kerbal technology, even if you can cheat, right? Here is my rocket. It is accelerating at about 25 Gs, right? And when time acceleration is set up to a factor of 4, that's almost a kilometer per second of acceleration per real world second, right? Now, if we were to do this to travel to another star, how far would we have to travel? Well, let's just take, our local solar neighborhood. The nearest stars are about 4 light years away. That's the nearest one, and we are actually a particularly sparsely populated part of the galaxy. It's quite common to find stars much closer together than that. But let's use 4 light years as the reference distance, right? So I'm looking at my speed here. My orbital speed is just past 70 kilometers per second. There, 72, right? Now, 72, if I take that at 72 kilometers per second, it would take a very, 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 very long time to get there. But we have time acceleration. Time acceleration, of course, will let us make time pass at 100,000 times normal speed. And that means that if you're traveling at 3 kilometers per second and you do a 100,000 time acceleration, that means that you're actually traveling at essentially light speed, albeit the game doesn't think you're traveling at that, but that's what it's like. So if you want to travel 4 light years in a year at 100,000 times time acceleration, you would need to travel 12 kilometers per second. Now, you see that our speed is about to reach 120 kilometers per second. That means that if we had time acceleration at maximum, we could get there in 1/10 of a year. So that's just over a month now I would have to leave the game running if I cut the power and let this accelerate and let this just fly off now. And 130, once this gets to 144 kilometers per second, of course, that will be 1 month. A mere 30 days of time acceleration. And I know, you guys have gone all the way out to ELU, have experienced how slow time acceleration can feel. There we go, 144 kilometers per second. 30 days of continuous time acceleration to reach another world after, 3 or 4 minutes of in-game time. Of course, we have infinite fuel, and we can keep on accelerating like this as long as we can. It took us about 10 minutes of acceleration to reach 1 month duration. That means if we continue to accelerate for another 10 minutes, so 20 minutes of game time, then we'll only have to time accelerate for 2 weeks. And that means 40 minutes will get us down to 1 week. And if we wait for an hour, an hour and 20 minutes, that will mean that it'll only take us half a week. But you see that the getting things shorter and shorter, we're eventually going to hit into some regime about 1 to 2 days of continuous game play to actually travel a 4 light-year distance. And that's not including, of course, the time that it would take to decelerate. Now, you can optimize this spacecraft just a little. You can, of course, put the pilot just in a seat with no protection around him, although at these accelerations, it's not uncommon for the pilot to actually fall out when you try to increase your physical time acceleration to 4 times normal speed. But, traveling at interstellar distances, at near interstellar speeds, of course, you then encounter other hazards. All those hydrogen atoms and stuff that are floating around, they suddenly become ionizing radiation that will give you cancer. Even the tiny grains of sand, if those hit you, they are highly energetic, they will demolish your entire spacecraft. And to be honest, the difference between sitting there in a spacesuit and sitting in that lander can, probably not that much difference, because they will hit you like a ton of explosives. Of course, my point is that to appreciate the huge distances that exist in this universe. Now, obviously, Kerbal Space Program makes things a little smaller, and, you know, we could certainly shrink these things down a whole lot to unphysically small distances. I wouldn't have a problem with that. Or if we were to add other star systems, you could have some other mechanism to get between them. You could, in fact, develop some hypothetical warp drive or something, which wouldn't exist in the real world. I personally like the concept of having to hunt around the solar system for monoliths and Easter eggs and use those to build a stargate, which will let you go to other star systems. Add a mini game in there. Now, the other question you might have is, how fast could you do it without using this cheat system? And it is actually possible to get up to speeds in excess of about 60 kilometers per second if you do things right and if you use all your fuel correctly by exploiting bioelliptic transfer and then doing a flypast to the sun and then dumping all your fuel there. You can easily get up to north of, into that realm, let's say. So you could cut the flight time certainly down to a few months, if you were lucky, if you were really dedicated. But it would take a really, really long time. So let's not be doing that. Let's hope that if new systems are added, the developers come up with some new and fascinating way for us to reach the stars. But until then, I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.